Hello, my friends, and welcome to Paulina Art. Today, I'm going to be painting these beautiful pansies. I've named this painting Pansies Party because they all seem so happy together, having a good time. Now, what I wanted to create in this painting was a little bit of a rustic effect with an old rusted bucket and an old gardening tool, as if we have just planted these pansies on the pot. Everything that I've done in this painting is in the video. The only thing I did off camera was just added a little bit of grass in some areas and splatter my painting with some red, orangey red paint, because that's what I like to do. That's how I like to finish most of my florals. If you want to paint these beautiful pansies, stay with me and let's paint. Today I'm working on a 9x12 canvas board. This was an inexpensive canvas board from the dollar store. And what I did to prepare my canvas board is I coated it with gesso. I did a coat of gesso last night. I normally prepare my canvas boards and all my canvases this way. I find it is much easier to paint when I have prepared my canvas board prior to painting. What I've done, I have my pattern right here. I place my pattern where I wanted it to be, and I measure from the bottom to the line where my pot is going to be sitting, and that's about 3¼ inches. So I've measured that on my canvas board and I traced the line. So I'm going to start doing the background. I also put a little dot on the center of my canvas board because once my background is done, I want to align my pot right in the center. This is what I choose for my composition because I want all these beautiful pansies to be right in the center of the painting. I'm going to do my background first because I don't want to lose my pattern on the background with the paint. So I'm going to do my background first. I'm going to start with my vintage white, my perfect purple, and real brown. And I've created this purpley, and I'm going to do the background, as you all know, quick, easy, and effective way using a sponge, which I run through water. I squeeze the water out and dried it a bit with a towel. So I'm gonna dip my sponge and I'm gonna start doing the top part of my background. I can add a little bit of darker purple in some areas. My background doesn't have to be perfect by any means. While this dries, I'm gonna do the bottom part. This is where my pot is gonna be sitting. I've mixed a little bit of my classic green with my real, with a drop of real brown to create this browny green color. And this is what I'm gonna use for the bottom using the clean side of my sponge. And this time I'm gonna go more like on a horizontal way. And I'm also going to add a few little sponge tops at the back to create maybe the effect of a little bit of greenery there. I want to create the effect as if the pot was sitting on grass that is just starting to grow, the beginning of the spring. I don't want this perfect. I want it to be nice and loose, because this, what's important is going to be my pot with the flowers. With a soft round brush, we're gonna soften up a little bit of the sky. If you watch my videos, you're gonna know that I really like using this old makeup brush. It's a Real Techniques crease brush, but it works extremely well. I'm picking up a little bit of the white, very, very little. And with this, I'm going to soften up a little bit the back of the sky. I am happy with the way my background is looking. I'm gonna let it dry for a few minutes and I'm gonna trace my pattern on top of it. And to do that, I'm going to align this line with the back, how I measured it. When I look at my pattern, I can see some of the little green above the line, and this is what I want. So I'm gonna place my pattern in here and I'm gonna trace it over. Okay, my friends, I have traced my pattern onto my background. I'm gonna attach a link to this pattern on the description box below. It's gonna be a link to my Facebook page where this pattern is gonna be in case you want to download it. Now, the first thing I'm gonna do, I'm going to pick up some white paint, my vintage white, and I'm gonna paint this pot and I'm gonna paint this gardening tool because acrylic paint is very translucent and I don't want these colors to show through. For that, I'm just gonna use a round brush and I'm gonna cover this. I'm gonna leave the lines that define the tools and the bucket so I don't end up with just two white blobs of paint. While my pot and my gardening tool dries, I'm gonna go in between the flowers. We're gonna add a little bit of green. I'm gonna pick up my classic green and I'm gonna warm it up a little bit with yellow. I want it to be a nice warm green. And with this, I'm gonna tap around here, just a little tap because I want it to look like greenery more so than anything else. Instead of a big blob of green, I wanted to have the feel of greenery. So I'm gonna tap in between my pansies. And with my liner brush, I'm gonna add some of the greenery at the top. I'm just adding some random little branches and greenery up here. I want this painting to be nice and loose, that they don't have to be perfect. Now, the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna add some of the outer leaves at the top here. These ones at the front, I'm gonna leave them. I'm gonna paint the pot first before I do those ones, but we can go ahead and do some of the outer leaves. And for that, I'm going to use this angle brush. This is a Medine number 6. You can use a flat brush if you prefer. For me, I find it easier to use an angle brush when I do my one stroke technique. And the way I choose my brush is I press it and I make sure this brush is going to do the job that I want the brush to do. And for the leaves, I feel this one is going to work out really well. I have dipped my brush in water and removed the excess water. I'm going to pick up some of my gel medium, just a little bit. And I'm going to pick up my main color, which is going to be my classic green. On the tip of the brush, I'm going to add a little bit of yellow and a little bit of white. And these are the colors that I'm gonna use for my leaves. I'm gonna start with this big leaf at the back, and I'm just gonna press my brush, and I'm gonna move it nice and gently, creating the leaf. And then I'm gonna do the other side of the leaf. The same way, I'm gonna press my brush, and I'm gonna finish the leaf. I'm gonna do this one now. This one has a little bit more yellow on the tip. Just make sure your brush is always nicely coated with paint. Now this, I'm going to go over that leaf and a little bit over this pansy, but that's okay. I'm going to press and follow. What we can do is with our round brush, with a little bit of water, we can remove some of the green paint that went on our pansy. I'm going to paint this other leaves that are right here the same way I did this ones, and I'll be back with you shortly. Okay, my friends, my leaves are done. If I went over some of my flowers, I just used this damp, not wet, but just damp brush, and I cleaned it up a little bit like that to remove the paint. My bucket is dry and my gardening tool is dry as well. Now I want to create the effect of just an old rusty bucket, and I'm going to mix some black and some gray and maybe a little drop of purple to create the color that I want for the bucket. I have my licorice, my black color. I have some white and some purple, and I'm going to add a little bit of medium blending gel, because I don't like to use a lot of water when I paint with my acrylics. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix a color that I feel looks like all metal. Maybe I'm going to add a little drop of purple in there. And this is going to be my main color for the bucket and the gardening tool as well, for the blade of the gardening tool. I'm still leaving the lines that tell me what my tool looks like. While this dries, I'm going to paint the handle of my gardening tool. And for that, I'm going to mix a little bit of red with brown. Gardening tools usually have handles this color for some reason. And I'm going to start adding dimension to the bucket and the gardening tool with some white, some shades of the same gray, darker gray, lighter gray, and a little bit of white. Gonna add a little bit of gray in here to create some dimension, darker gray. With my liner brush, I'm gonna define the center. Gonna add a little bit of white on the blade here. We're going to leave it for now. We're going to work on our bucket. We can add a little bit of brown, make it look like it's a little bit rusty. I'm going to add a little bit of brown with red. I'm going to let that dry. I'm going to add a little bit more white on the tool. Okay, my friends, we're going to let all this dry. While our bucket dries, we're going to paint this leaf that is right here. We're going to do this leaf at the end. It's in front of that pansy, so we're going to paint that pansy first. At this point, I'm going to start painting my pansies. Now pansies come in many colors, so you can be as creative as you want painting your pansies. The colors that I chose for this composition are purples and oranges and yellows and a little bit of red. So that's what I'm going to be painting my pansies. We're going to start from this back petal, then I'm going to paint this one, then this one, two, and then the last one, this one. So basically we're gonna work from the back to the front of our flower. I'm gonna paint them all within the same colors, but a little bit different. I'm gonna start with this one. And I'm gonna use the same number 6 brush. I'm gonna dip my medium, my gel medium, just a little bit so the paint flows nicely. I'm gonna pick up my bright red on the toe and yellow at the heel of my brush. I'm gonna mix on this plate. And I'm gonna start with the back petal. And I'm gonna do this petal coming on top. For these two petals, I'm gonna use orange and purple. So I'm gonna pick up orange and a little bit of white at the toe. And I'm gonna pick purple at the heel. And I'm gonna do the side petals. Just pressing my brush. Here we're gonna do the same with the one going this way. It doesn't matter if it's not perfect. We want this composition to be nice and loose and painterly. Now we're gonna do the bottom petal. And for that, I'm gonna use yellow and white. The white just adds a nice thickness to the yellow, basically. And we're gonna add purple on the heel. I'm gonna move my canvas board so it's easier for me and you can see pretty good what I'm doing here. I'm gonna press my brush. I'm gonna cover a little bit of those petals because this last petal is the largest one and it's over this two. And we have our first beautiful, colorful pansy. So all my pansies don't look the same, and to make it a little bit more interesting, I'm gonna paint this one in purples. I'm gonna create a light purple, and I'm gonna put some white on the heel of the brush like that. And I'm gonna start with the back petal. I'm gonna do the one that is on top of that one. This petal at the bottom is like a wing of a butterfly. We're gonna paint this pansy now. I'm gonna show you the colors that I choose for every pansy. Of course, you can do your own variation of colors. These pansies are all done. We're gonna do the little ones up here. And I'm just gonna press and do this petal over here first. And the second petal is gonna come like this. Here we're gonna start with the bottom petal. And we're gonna do the top one. All our pansies are done. We're gonna let this dry and we're gonna finish our pot. Actually, let's finish this leaf here. We're going to paint it exactly the same as we did the other leaves. This one is going to be on top of that pansy, and that's okay. We're going to let all these beautiful flowers dry. We're going to finish our bucket. We're just going to add a little bit of dimension to our bucket. We don't want it to look absolutely perfect because the bucket is not the main focus of the painting. The pansies are. With our liner brush, we're going to pick up some of our dark purpley gray that we mixed. I'm going to do some of the lines here that define my bucket. Once we're happy with our pot and our gardening tool, we are going to add some brown shadows at the bottom here, mixing some of our brown and green and a little bit of our mix, our gel medium. Now we're going to add the stems of the pansies that are right here. And I have green on my toe and yellow on my heel on my angled brush. I'm still using the same brush. I'm gonna press and slide. And I'm gonna press here and here. And with the same brush, we are going to add some leaves, some little leaves everywhere. And for that, we're only going to press and slide just like that. The last thing we need to do is add the center of our beautiful pansies. To add the center of our pansies, all we need is a Q-tip, and we're gonna dip it in our yellow. And we're gonna put a little dot in the middle of each pansy. And we're gonna wait for that to dry. We're gonna finish the center of our pansies with our liner brush. We're going to pick up a little bit of white and we're going to do a little inverted V right above the little yellow dot. And your pansies are done, my friends. Okay, my friends, we have come to an end of this beautiful painting of our bright and colorful pansies. If you enjoy this painting, please give it a like, share it with your friends. One last thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna splatter some nice bright orangey red above my flowers. I hope you enjoyed this painting. If you did, share it with your friends. Give me a like, subscribe to my channel if you don't wanna miss any content from me. I thank you so much for watching. I will see you on the next one.